A controversial plan to shut down parks like Sutter's Fort here in Sacramento was shelved by Governor Schwarzenegger, but budget troubles continue and park advocates say they want to tap car owners to keep the system whole. Joining me this morning is Traci Verardo-Torres with the California Parks Foundation. Welcome, Traci.
Good morning.
As I mentioned, your group is trying to qualify for the November ballot, a measure that would essentially put an $18 fee on people's car registration annually to pay for parks. What's the thinking here?
Well, it's a modest investment. It's really $1.50 a month that we're asking Californians to pay to keep their state parks open, and the benefits are threefold. One, we don't suffer the threats of parks closing. Two, we get a dedicated source of funding for state parks. But most attractive to most Californians is they'll get free day use access to their state parks.
So that's part of the deal here, is that anyone with a car who is registered in California would have free day access.
Absolutely. Right now, if you're going to state parks, you're paying on average $12 to $15 to get in the gate just once. And this is asking Californians to pay $18 once a year every time they're registering their vehicles. And that essentially buys them an annual pass, which right now is worth $125 a year. So it's a very modest investment.
You are going to be encountering some built-in opposition, especially in this tough economic climate, from people who are already struggling to pay their bills, looking for jobs and so forth. How do you address that concern?
Well, we address it twofold. One is the state park system actually generates money for the state, so that we know every dollar we invest in state parks brings $2.35 back to the state's general fund. So by supporting state parks, we're actually in an economic stimulus proposal here. Two, the new funding for state parks will actually provide some job creation, because we've got a $1.2 billion backlog in state parks right now. Those are jobs that we could have folks in the construction trade, in local law enforcement, other professions. We can be putting people back to work if we can invest in
state parks.
You're
talking about maintenance, right?
Maintenance and operations of state parks, absolutely.
Why not simply boost park fees?
Well, as you may remember, that was a proposal, and actually on last August, the legislature and the governor did direct the state park system to do that. And in some cases, we've seen camping fees double. We've seen these day use fees increase. And, for better or for worse, sometimes there are easy ways to avoid paying the fees, parking outside and walking in and those types of things. So we really think that we've got to get state parks off this budget roller coaster. $1.50 a month for Californians to pay for their state parks is really a very small investment to ask.
And have you done some polling about people's receptivity to the idea?
We have. I mean, this is an idea, particularly with state parks closing, that has been very popular over the last couple of years. At the end of the year, we looked at public support, and we're very confident that we're going to get the public support when we go to the ballot this November.
Now, the governor has made an interesting budget proposal this year, as you know. He is seeking to cut state parks by some $140 million, replace that with revenues from a proposed offshore oil project off the Santa Barbara coast, the so-called T Ridge project. This leaves park advocates in an interesting situation of either facing cuts or supporting expanded offshore drilling, right?
Well, it is another game of political brinksmanship that we've seen this administration play with state parks. I mean, over the last 3 years, they proposed twice to shut down state parks, twice to eliminate general fund altogether of state parks, and now this oil drilling proposal. Interestingly, the legislative analyst last week even said that this is not an appropriate tie-in with the parks funding and with oil money. So state park advocates are disappointed that we continue to see these public kind of political games. That's why we're going to the ballot, and we're going to take it to the voters.
And where are you right now in terms of the deadline and signature gathering?
We're well more than halfway toward our goal for signature gathering. In fact, I think we're more than three-quarters of the way there. We're going to be pushing toward the end. We've got thousands of volunteers out on the street actually collecting. They're in front of REIs and supermarkets and farmers markets every weekend. We're going to meet our goals. We're wrapping up signature gathering in mid-April, get this out to the counties in May, and then we'll expect to have California see this on the ballot on November 2nd.
It's an expensive process.
It can be an expensive process, but this is really something we've seen people in their grassroots community spend time and spend energy to go out and take a few hours every Saturday and Sunday to stand in front, even in the wet and cold weather we had a couple months ago, to stand out and ask people for their support, and the support has been overwhelming, so we're confident.
Where would the parks be without this particular funding source as we look ahead to this coming fiscal year?
Well, we'd be back in these kind of political games, and as you know, the governor did propose not just this link of the money to oil, but he actually did propose for the second time to eliminate all state core funding for the state park system. We're seeing this happen in other states, too. New York is closing state parks. Arizona is closing state parks. even though we didn't have that full general fund reversal that the governor wanted last year, we still have about 75 parks that are partially or seasonally closed, and we're not sure if they're going to reopen. Springtime, people are starting to think about summer vacations. I mean, this is the time when people are most looking for their state parks to be available. And this is why we're going to the ballot. We just can't afford as a state to continue to underfund and defund our state parks like this.
And we should point out a lot of parks are open partially. They're not open fully like they used to be.
That's correct. I mean, they may be closed for several days out of the week. They may be closed for several months out of the year. And that's something with this initiative. We would be taking that off the table. Californians would not have to worry about, you know, when their kids are going to their school field trips at Sutter's Fort, they'd be able to get there. When they're wanting to go camping in Tahoe, they'd be able to get there.
All right, we're going to leave it there. Traci Verardo-Torres with the California Parks Foundation. Thanks very much.
Thank you.